Hello guys, welcome back to a brand new video. In today's video, I'm gonna give you my tips and tricks on how to actually level up the natural CSC as quickly as possible. I did it in probably 2 or 3 days without even grinding, so it's a pretty easy way or pretty easy method. This video is gonna be divided in 2 sections. The first one is gonna be the level 1 to level 5, because this is the hardest to get. And then later on in the video, we're gonna check out just a simple quick tip on how to do it from 5 to 20. I'm also gonna give you some tips and tricks that you should do and don't do, because this is pretty easy to do. Okay, so let's get started. So the first thing you need to do is go ahead and go to Strawberry to actually get the mission. This mission will start if you go into the hotel or the motel, whatever you want to call it. You see a little yellow area on your map. Just go in there and the mission will start automatically. After the shortcut, you will need 25 gold bars. If you do not have the money, then you cannot start it. So you do need 25 gold bars, so keep an eye on that. So once we actually did pay the money, and we can now go out and go and do some hunting, the first thing we're going to do is locate Harriet. She is the woman that we need to find, and she is the woman that we buy everything from. We're not going to go out and find Gus. We're not going to do anything with Gus right now. We just need Harriet to level up as quickly as possible. So once you do actually get to Harriet, the first thing we're going to buy is some Varmint Rifle sedatives. This will get you the ability to actually sedate an animal. That way we can get a sample. But this will also need you to have a Varmint Rifle. If you do not have a Varmint Rifle, then go out and buy one. The second thing is we are going to buy some revivers. Again, revivers are pretty expensive. Later on we can craft some if you want that, but I don't do it. I just buy them from 1 to 5, and after 5 I don't even take a reviver with me anymore. So now once you have both, you can go out into the world and go out and sedate some animals. Do not kill the animals, because you will not get any XP from that. And Harriet will only get madder at you, and eventually will not be able to sell to her for a couple of minutes. So now you sedated a rabbit. So now you have sedated your first animal. So what you need to go do now is go up to the rabbit and press the sample button. This will get you a sample that we can later outsell to Harriet. So now go and do this for an hour or two to actually get a good amount of samples. Shoot everything you see, shoot everything you move. Only do not shoot horses, cats, or dogs, because these will not get you anything. So once you did it for an hour or two, you have a good amount of sedatives or a good amount of samples, you can go back to Harriet and start selling them. This will actually get you some experience from your role and from your actual outlaw pass. If you do have the outlaw pass or you bought it, then later on you can get some extra XP. It's not much, but it's definitely something that will eventually add up. So now you are probably still level 1, level 2, level 3, depending on which level you are. Now we have to do it all over again until we reach level 5. It's gonna take a long time. The first 5 levels are the hardest, and this is gonna be a lot of work to actually do. So now once you're level 5, there are a few things we are going to check out. You can now start some free roam missions, which we are not going to do. This will give you a good amount of experience as well, but we're not gonna do them, because if you don't do them correctly or if you don't do them good, you will not get a good amount of XP. You can also go out and do some Gus things. You can go out and search for the legendary animals, and you can go out and sell them and kill the animal and sell Gus the animal parts and the animal coats, skins, whatever you want to call them. You can go out and do that, but we're not gonna do that. We're not going over to Gus, because he will not give you anything, only money. And we're not looking for money, we're just looking for the experience to land grab right now. So now you can also start some missions. You can poach missions, you can do all kinds of missions that you can do. But we're not going to do any of those. We're going to forget about missions, we're going to forget about the free roam sessions events, we're going to forget about Gus. The only thing we're going to do now is go over to the legendary maps of the animals that Harriet gives you. It's a mission. It's under missions, you can go out and check them. So what you need to do now is press X on your controller if you're on PC or PlayStation 4. Just do on anything, probably like 2 or 3 sections you can do, probably three or maps you can do. Just take the one you like and then go and start it up. So once you load it in, there are a few things we need to take a look at. We need to actually go out and track the animal. So once you go out, you find the track, you found the animal eventually, you can go now and sedate the animal. Do not kill the animal again. If you go and kill the animal, you can only take it back to Gus, and this will not give you experience. This will only give you money, and that's it. If you take an animal, you can probably go to Gus and bring it to Gus, get money, and you probably Gus can make it like an outfit of it. We do not need that, we just need the actual experience. So what I do recommend is you go out and sedate the animal. This will probably take a while. If you're, for example, you're hunting wolf, you're hunting the legendary Moonstone Wolf, this will take a while because you probably die a couple of times just because the wolf does have some other friends with him, some other friends in the wolf pack, and they will kill you and they will go after you until you're actually done. So what I do recommend is don't try to sedate all of them. Just shoot all of them except the legendary animal. You can sedate all of them. This will only cost you more time and you'll probably only die more and more and more. So that is a thing you can do if you want that. But if you don't want to do that, then just shoot the animal. So once we actually start the legendary mission, depending on what you're looking for, depending on what animal you choose, we have to start tracking the animal. So this will do by activating Eagle Eye. This will eventually get up to the animal. You see like a little yellow glowing part. That way you need to investigate or you need to inspect, and then you get a path that you need to focus on, again, with your Eagle Eye. Eventually, after doing some tracking, you will get by the animal. I do not recommend you shoot it. I do not recommend you kill it. You just go out and get the sedatives out of your vomit rifle. You start shooting it a couple times. Keep in mind, guys, some animals do eventually attack you. Some animals will go out and attack you. Or some animals do have some friends that want to attack you as well. So keep an eye on that. Just sedate the legendary animal. Once that it's sedated, once that it's actually down, you can go out and go up to the animal and press the square button. Again, if you're on PS4, just take the sample of the animal. Now, you cannot do the reviving. So that's why I recommend only buying the level 1 to 5 the revivers. And if you want to go out and, for example, you're level 6 or 5, don't go out and buy revivers because we won't use it. So once you sedate the animal, you go up to the animal and you press to take the samples. This will ultimately bring you back to another freedom session with the samples with it and also some experience. This will give you experience, and now we're going to get some more experience. So what we need to do now is go up to Harriet back again. What you can do on the way back is you can sedate some animals, take the samples, but this will cost you time. So that's why I don't do it. I just ride straight to Harriet and that's it. So now once you're at Harriet, you can sell it, and now you can see, as you can sell it, you have 2 times the experience from that mission. That means that once you complete the mission, you get experience. Once you meet, go to Harriet, and once you meet Harriet, and once you sell the legendary samples, this will also give you experience. So in total, for 20 minutes of time, you probably get somewhere around 600, 500, 600, 700 experience for doing one mission. So this means by 4-ish missions, you are ranked up. Depending on how fast you are, this will mean you probably rank up every hour. So it's pretty simple depending on how fast you are. So that's the way I do it. I know you can go out and do some poacher missions, but I don't do the poacher missions. I only do the poacher missions once the 2 or 3 legendary maps are gone and I cannot do them. I need to wait to refresh them. Then I'll go out and do some poacher missions until I go out and do some hunting. But other than that, I don't do it. I just mainly do Harriet's legendary animals, and that's it. So now this will rank you up, like I said, probably every hour you rank up once. It's pretty simple, it's pretty easy depending on how fast you can track them, depending on how fast you can hunt them, and this will rank you up, like I said, once or twice every hour, depending on how fast you are again. So now we can also do the freedom session. I do not recommend doing the freedom session because this will only cost time, and if you don't do them correctly, if you don't do them good, then you will get nothing and you get little to no XP. So do not do that. Again, also don't go out once you're level 5. Do not buy revivers. You get revivers if you really want revivers, then do a free roam session mission, something of those events, because these will give you some free revivers. But otherwise, don't do them. Okay, so that's it. Thanks for watching the video, guys. If you do enjoy the video, definitely like and subscribe. If you follow this step the way I did it, you probably rank up, like I said, every hour once, depending on fast you are, you can do, or fast you do the missions, you rank up every hour-ish, depending on how fast you are. So it's pretty easy, it's pretty fast. if you just mainly do the things I said, this will rank you up pretty easy. So thanks for watching the video, guys. If you do enjoy the video, then definitely like and subscribe. And I hope to see you out in my next video. Bye, guys. See you later.